Hey guys, it's BlueLink25 here, and today I am doing another mob battle. I know I did one yesterday about the Hercules Beetle. Well, I'm doing another one. Mainly because I thought I'd do two. I mean, why not? Oh, that would make me think about if you want to see more. After I just do two or three. But yeah, today is we're doing another mob battle. If you guys don't know what it is, it's basically a bunch of mobs fighting against each other. It's really powerful. They're actually pretty powerful. I'm using all of them for spawn because that's one of the best mods to do this with. So today we have the Cephadrome Forces fighting for the main guy for today is the Cephadrome. 300 hit points, oh, throw him off. He's like a dragon, 300 hit points, hits incredibly hard, and used to be one of the strongest mobs ever. And he can survive a hit from the Slice. Now, the Slice is actually a different version of the Big Bertha. Yeah, that's how hard it is. So, today, these are actually really powerful mobs. We have to go from weak to strong, guys. So, we have Sea Viper, the Rubber Pounder, the Nasty Source, the Jumpy Bug, Leonopterus. I think it's powerful, that's why I just switched it up. Hercules Beetle, and finally, Caterpillar. And actually, I have two mobs here. And no, that word I'm gonna explain later when we get to this title. Anyway, yeah, let's begin with the Sea Viper. This is my last mob battle. This dude is like a water snake, 150 HP. I guess it kind of hits on like some bosses, but like yeah, it was a fortune to me, and pretty sure it's kind of sad that he's not on. Angry that he's not on one. But let's begin. Cephadrome. 7 damage. 36. 8 damage. As you saw that he just regenerated. That all bosses have this. The regenerate. But he was at 292 before he regenerated it all. And I feel like because they got owned so bad, I gotta do like 5 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on, dude. The one thing the Cephadrome, in my opinion, is pretty bad about is he will only focus on one after the other one, so forget the other one after he gets it. Oh boy. I believe. Yeah. 3. Dead. And dead. 215. Not bad. He was 218 because of his. I let the poison take hold. Now the next one is actually kind of hard to do without me cutting because the next mob actually breaks blocks. Here's the thing, it's a dude that will, since the Cephadrome has Incend Knockback, it will keep, I'm going to put him next to the Rubber Pounder, 200 hit points but like an iron golem, go! 19. Dude! Yeah dude, as you can see he's like swinging his arm. Look at that angle. One damage? No way. 11 damage. Yeah, as you can see, like that's how far he knocked it. The mob will actually lose its aggro. And if I were to show you how to rip my arena. Just increase my arena. Dude! Put him back down! 7 damage? Yeah. Not much of a difference. But the next mob is actually pretty surprising that it's coming in third. It is the Nasty Source. 200 hit points. Really large. One of my best dinosaur opinions because of its teeth and. Of course it smells awful. Here we go. 22 damage? 11 damage! OMG! What? Maybe if like a team of Nappy Sources. Oh. That's like the best time so far in one of them. But, what I'm gonna do. That's actually pretty unique. It's actually. It does 11 damage. I would say 2 would be best, but to make it unique, we're doing 3. Go for it. And let's see if by a team. Come on, they do 11 damage, but normal Cephadrome heals. All Master Sources are one half dead. All of them are half dead. Epidrome is not even. Come on, dudes! What is this? Oh, one's about to die. Yep, one dead. 180. My team, that's why I love it. Very good. But the next one of it, you guys might have seen it, and that's why my arena looks different. I actually increased it just a bit. Hoping that the jumping bug is not able to jump out. Just because it's definitely able to, I'm just going to get snowballs. Go! A minion right off the bat. Wow, this jumping bug knows. Yeah, dude, keep summoning those minions. Oh, I summoned another one. Oh, the jumping bug's about to die. It's just too rich, big bug. And they did about 50. They gone down to 250. That's actually not bad of a attempt. 50. But I'm going to do one more just to see how it would do. How it would do. I'll fix that this day. So that's what we all know this morning. They actually managed to spawn one off down to. Wow. Yeah. But the next mob is actually pretty strong. Me and not 258 points. I actually put the Hercules Beetle after this because well they're basically the Eagle strike. Yeah, 25, so it's not gonna really. But yeah. Come on, dude. Dude, 17 damage. OMG, 20. Really good. Come on, dude, keep smacking him. No. 188, about the same as a team. That shows you guys how powerful this guy is. But I want to do one more. It looks like he was glitching out, so I'll spawn him next to. Oh, this time the battle is actually beginning right after that. So 20 damage, but Leonox is already half dead. And Stephodrome is not even half dead. 240. Basically, you can get down to 180. You can get him down to 180. The next mob, I'm actually curious about. Hercules Beal. If you saw my last mob, he was tough. But there's one reason why this mob is more powerful. Yeah, Hercules Beetle. If you haven't seen it before, 250 hit points, and here's the thing. It knocks enemies up so they take fall damage. I wish that the Sub-Room couldn't take fall damage, but it's actually immune. Here we go. But it does have high reach. 10 damage. Like, look at that. It would take fall damage, but as you guys know, both of them I can actually heal up. But the Sub-Room, I can only does more damage. So this deal about half dead and Stephodrome 50. Yeah, keep knocking him. Stephodrome, because if yeah. Down to 198 and this is just 1-on-1. I say that lean objects. Oh no. Almost down halfway just five. So in my opinion, just because he's I want to do two. This is them guys, one-on-one count, but sure. I just want to see how it would go against the Sephiroth versus two of them. Remember guys, he takes no fall damage, so that's the reason why I'm doing two. Of course, my opinion, if the Sephiroth were to take fall damage, the Hercules Beetle would win, but hey. Ooh. The Sephiroth is actually almost half dead. Let's see, this one's almost not half dead, that one is. Low half and that finally in a 2-on-1 it's actually below half. Below half and 87. Tap Stephodrome is all down 90. Yeah, 90. If one dies, it's game over, I think. Okay. Here comes one. 8 and 37. Whoa. battle at Pro Bowl. But the next dude is actually super unique. The next dude is actually why I have blocks. Oakwood. If you guys don't know, this mob has a really cool ability, which is actually Meat Caterkiller, 450 HP, it's not. See that move? If you place down a block of wood, it will eat it in the fight. It actually eats wood to heal. So for the first round, I'm just going to make it fight normally, and also does webs. But I'm going to make it fight normally, and then I'm going to let you guys see. I'm going to place down some wood, and I'll do it. Here we go, Suffadrone. So as you can see, he's placing down wood on the Suffadrone, which is good. Yeah, as you can see, normally, if you fight normal, it's not really well. It's below half already. I feel sore. The Suffadrone down to 2. But remember, guys, I'm going to place down wood so that it will actually die to see how it will be. So, I have to first clean this up. Yeah, it makes a huge mess. But anyway, time to put down some wood. I'm gonna put wood everywhere. Oops! Anyway, that should be enough wood. So yeah, guys. The wood is going to be around so that as the caterpillar fights, it will actually heal itself by these wood. So yeah, let's make it hard. Anyway, this is how good the mob is. Yo, so watch the wood. I believe it will eat. Look at that! It's eating the wood, and by doing this, it's healed itself. Keep an eye on the wood, guys. Tell me if you guys see any differences. Look at that regeneration. This is why I was excited. Can the Suffadrone beat the Caterpillar with its like high regenerative ability? It's below half. Eat the wood so that it gets heat. Absolutely. Unfortunately, Caterpillar. Oh, eat that wood. You have a chance. Look at that regeneration, 202. Unfortunately, that is it. Down to 188. But as you can see, guys, the caterpillar hit is really good when there's like wood around. When you have wood, because well, it will eat it. But in my opinion, you might notice that I have two mobs when I'm trying to like maybe like fix my arena. You might notice I have two mobs that and those are the Nightmare and the Prince. The Prince is actually really strong, so that's why I did it, but that's not the case. There's a reason I put the Nightmare. If you guys don't know, the Nightmare is really unique. It spawns in different sizes, so as a fun round, I decided to put it as like him and the Prince as a bonus round. Why? Because, well, the Suffadrone hits really hard, but like, of course, he has to be able to defeat it by stuff. So, because of that, we're going to make it so that he fights both of them. The Suffadrone. Now, I'm going to go up to 500 because you guys don't know. I know that the Suffadrone is really hard. It's really hard, but in my opinion, I say that 100, like 750 or. Are way too powerful for it. So we're going to just make it fight with going to divide the weakest go. Like 39 and 5 damage. Wow. Now if you guys are curious, there is a side that I want to, that if you do want to get. I'm gonna quickly kill this up to him. And that is 500. Go! Now, 20 damage, but like 20. Now, this is really close. Nightmare is really fun. Cephadrome, half dead. But there's also, it's also half dead. 250. Well, 171. Oh. Eight health remaining. So yeah, guys, as you can see, it's really powerful. It's just that there's one size I want to show you guys. The size before you get basically it goes by order. Here we go. 250. It's the second weakest. But in my opinion, sometimes it can actually work. I was doing at 240. See, some it actually does better than the others, but this is the one I want to do. I want to get like a 750, and I'm going to have like a team. And by the way, I'm not going to do like 3 250s because, if I don't know, every nightmare had different attack powers. For example, 250 will only hit as hard as like 550 will hit much harder because it's a stronger version. Well, guys, I'm just gonna spawn some in and we'll see. One. Mom! 500. That's it. That's it, we're just going to move on to the next round because, well, I'd love to do it, guys, it's just that it would take way too long. It would just take way too long because of how it's just a chance. I will do one more spawn egg. If it does not work, well, yep, the weakest one. Yeah. So the next one is the prince. The prince is actually super unique, mainly because of its size. The prince can come in many different sizes, but for the we're going to make the 7 for every single one. So this is the prince, 500 hit points. Really sad that I have to make it fight the Cephadrome, but yeah. Really? Don't fight this? Don't fight the Cephadrome? Well then, just give you guys an idea of what I'm talking about. If I spawn like a nasty source, it will battle it. Apparently, it doesn't fight people, and unfortunately, it can't fight because I'm really sad that this thing can't fight, mainly because of how many sizes this thing can get. But I'm just going to spawn in a bunch of nightmares. Yeah. Oops. Yeah, as you can see, it's a kind of like a pet. Maybe that's why, because the Cephadrome is kind of like a pet because you can just summon it. We got it, 750. Now, remember guys, as I mentioned, they hit, they have higher defense and can hit much harder. Like, demonstrated by the prince, it's. Hey, dude! Oh no. Go! And I'm just going to spawn in like a lot of Cephadrones because it actually hits pretty hard. Look at that wave of Cephadrones. But keep in mind guys, this actually hits really hard. 32! And look at that, they're like yeah. But keep in mind the nightmare does come to them, so even if they have a chance to heal, the nightmare will eventually come and kill them of course, so that's why I'm not pushing them up. It's actually almost dead. But I'm looking at the Cephadrones. Oh, actually, some of the ones that didn't fight. Yeah, guys. But that is about it. As you can see, Cephadrones are really hard. They're like really freaking hard. They're really strong against like other mobs because like as you remember I demonstrated they hit really hard. But yeah guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode of today's mob battle because seriously, I do my best to post these. Oh my god, I'm kinda like a beginner so I can't really like cut and stuff, but eventually I will figure those out. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you do, be sure to leave a like and hit that like button. And yeah, I will see you guys next time. See ya!